Yay! All right, hello! Welcome to the first block of the second day of Fantastic Arcade. I'm really excited to announce our joint panel here with Kenny Sun and Jenny Jiao Hsia. So each of them are going to be going through some of their games, prototypes, things that they've worked on. We have a joint panel here. I just found out actually they both, for those of you that were here last year, they actually did their panel together last year. While they didn't work together on their games, they're actually both, they both attended the same game program at NYU. So that's the connection there. I just learned about that today. So that's pretty cool. Former classmates, both here at Fantastic Arcade showing games. Kenny Sun is a creator of Yankai's Triangle, and Jenny's got Daily Motions, which is a collection of minigames, and I'm sure they'll be talking about those games as well as some other stuff in today's panel. So if you have questions, this is not like a formal presentation where we have to keep questions to the end. If you have questions while folks are presenting, feel free to throw your hand in the air. I'll be keeping an eye out for questions. And other than that, I'm going to go ahead and turn things over to Kenny.
All right. All right, so I'm just going to play some games. So this is the first game I ever made. Yeah, so the goal is to collect all the happy faces so you can go to the door. You didn't get out. Oh, no. And I only have one life left, so. Alright. That's the first game.
Do we need to turn the audio down on the laptop, or can you guys hear the mics and the audio okay? Turn the audio down on the computer so
down.
We can hear the mics better. Okay, perfect.
So I released that game on December 22nd, and then 3 days later, I released an update to it for some reason. It's first 1.5. Oh, I think I just made it easier. So now you have 100 lives. Oh, you can also shoot now. There's no shooting sound effect, though.
How did you make the graphics for this game?
I drew them in Flash, I think.
Flash.
And then I added this like a glow effect that Flash has. And I put that on everything. And I call it glow sticks. Anyway, that's pretty much the same thing. My next game came out the next year on January 20th. It's another glow game called Glow Bricks. It's pretty much just Brick Breaker. but there's like these falling little things that you can collect to get more points. Yeah, it's 14. Oh, what? All right, that's that game.
So were you sharing these games? Were you putting them online?
Yeah, I put them on Newgrounds. Oh, it's broke. So I used to be a Newgrounds person. And I put games on Newgrounds. Sound stopped. Okay, and then I feel like I'm going too fast. Anyway,
yeah, you should slow down.
I should slow down. All right. The next game came out 2 months later. It's an alphabet game.
Were you into like rave culture at this time?
No, I just found this music online for free. Then I just put them in my game. Look, the instructions are over here. Oh, wait. Yeah, so it's like, this game's kind of like Itch.io, or not Itch.io, Agar.io, except with letters. So you start off as A, you can only eat the other A's, and then you gain letters. So now that I'm a C, you can eat other C's. Oh, I disappeared. And now I'm an E.
How long did it take to make
that game?
I guess it took 2 months because it came out 2 months after the last game.
What inspired you to make it?
I don't remember. I was 14. That was like 9 years ago. It's weird.
Yeah, that's weird.
All the letters. Might be broken. I think it's broken. Oh, no, it can't. There it is. It broke. Yes, I guess Flash is old. Let's look at the credits. So my name's Mr. Sun. That was my moniker. That's my actual name too, kind of. I use lynda.com. the music is Vortex by Zacko. 5555000. Wanna check him out?
Somewhere he's on a panel talking about all the music he's done over the past 7 years.
Oh, I clicked on lynda.com. Anyway.
So what were you learning as you were making your first games? Do you think there are any kind of learnings that you took from that, or was it really just sort of experimenting, playing with Flash?
Learned how to make games, which is good. Learned how to program, which is good. I don't know. I didn't really think about design as a thing back then. Anyway. Oh, then, okay, this next one is my magnum opus. I was 15 this time.
Wow.
It's a xylophone game. It's kind of like... This is good. It's kind of like Guitar Hero, but with your keyboard, so it's like really hard. So you get the four, the eight keys. Oh no. This is bingo. No. All right, 2 stars. That's all right. That's all right. Let's go. We can go to the hard ones. I remember the Taco Bell's canon was pretty tough. This one's really tough.
Hello.
What?
I have a question.
Who's that?
When you were deciding on like what, if you remember, I know it was a long time ago.
Okay.
Why make a little like rhythm music game or the other things? Like, do you feel like that motivation was more just like curiosity about how you would make that kind of thing, or was something else going on?
You're right, I don't remember. No, this is tough. This one's also tough. So, I don't know, I like making things. I think I also put in a compose function. Oh, I think it still works. Should I do major or minor?
Oh, minor.
Minor?
Yeah.
Oh, so sad. Well, next page. Oh, wait, I skipped a beat. How do you delete? Do you know? I don't think you can delete it. Oh, it's stuck there.
Check game facts.
Game facts. Huh. Oh. What? You can... Okay. Oh, interesting. Oh, you can only... So you can only... If you have two, you can only delete the leftmost one. We can't delete... Oh, never mind. What?
So I'm curious, you know, I remember Newgrounds back at this time, but what was the, how are you interacting with people that were playing your games? Were people leaving you comments? Did you kind of like put things out there and then kind of not check up on them again? Or did you have a lot of interaction with people who were playing your games?
So yeah, I think Newgrounds has like a rating and review system. And I read them and they're usually nice, which is cool. And the games aren't too great. Oh, it's pretty good. Wait.
Are these games still online? Can we download them? Can we go to newgrounds.com?
Yeah, I think you can still play them, but they might not work. Because I remember trying to play the xylophone game, and online, like, all of the notes just don't appear for some reason. Mm. Anyway. What's the name of the song? Snake thing?
Anybody know the correct name of Snake Charmer tune?
All right, so now that I've exported this, I can, hopefully that copies it. Copy. I'm gonna play custom game now and paste the code here. And then.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Then I can add custom things like. I don't think this is gonna break. Let's see what happens. Oh no. Yeah. That's pretty cool. Anyway, that was my magnum opus. Everything after this was downhill. Oh yeah, it worked. All right, so then 6 months later, is there a question?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's possible. I don't think there's like, I didn't implement leaderboards or anything, so I never found out. But maybe.
Sounds like a challenge.
Yeah, you should do it. All right, next one. So this one is what?
You're gonna say something? I was just going to say impromptu tournament tonight.
Yeah. Okay, anyway. So next game, 2009. I think it was an unfinished prototype. Let's see how it goes. I don't think there's any sound. That's a defense game. Yeah. So you're just the guy defending your base.
Yeah, did you draw those?
I think so. Yeah, look at that guy. It's pretty cool.
Nice.
Oh yeah, I think the font didn't embed, but you can. I think there's like a base system. Oh, look at this! Look at all these things. What do they do? Oh, let's create some weapons. No, I can't. No, didn't make them. Let's train. I have 10 turns. Oh, yeah. Oh, I can't scavenge now. I can repair my base. Oh, that's full health. Anyway, let's go to the next level.
Did a particular game inspire that?
Some sort of tower defense game that I played when I was 15. Was I 15? Yeah, there are a lot of tower defense games on Newgrounds. And then I think the one I played was like desktop tower defense. Is that it? You know that?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, it was a cool one. It's not as cool as this, though. I'm a scavenge. Got some raw materials. I don't know what they do. Yeah, I can't. No, these aren't implemented yet. Well, I guess the entire game. I think there's nothing left. Wait, nails. No, train. Let's see what happens with experience. Yeah, I don't think these stats do anything. I didn't spend them. I did spend them. You can see a little stat underscore something. Because I think normally you're supposed to play these in like the same, what is it called? Same screen.
Universe.
No, screen resolution. Mm. Not resolution, but dimensions. Yeah, screen dimensions. Otherwise, the things that are on the side that are like supposed to be hidden are not.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so that's why
it's an aspect ratio.
Yeah, yeah. So these are all like 2, 3, and this laptop's like 16:9. I think this is how far I got with this game.
Do you still have the source code for this?
Yeah, you want to see it? I don't know if it might not compile. Yeah, let's see.
I mean, it's actually pretty amazing that, at the young age you were making these games, you were keeping the source code. Like, I know everything I made before I was, 22 is, gone. So it was very smart of you to have such an archival...
Oh, there's so much stuff in here. I think this is a defense game. Oh, you want to say new defense?
Ooh.
Ooh, you want a new game? I'm going to continue. I'm continuing. Oh, look at how much better it is. Oh, look. There's help, but there's nothing. There's nothing there. All right, scavenge. Oh, man, the buns are so good. Nice. Yeah. Oh, look at all these things at the bottom. Look at that. Undefined damage? Wow. Oh, I got an authoritator. The cannon authoriturate. Oh, look at that. Oh, I made AI. Man, so smart. Well, look at them. They're all bunching together, though. Oh, they're all going to be one thing eventually. Oh, it also made... Oh, now it's ray casting. Yeah.
Ooh.
Look at... Wow. Great animation. Oh. All right, trained. Wait. Can I spend? Oh, yes, the same thing. I don't think these buns do anything. Oh, SS. Look at all that SS. Oh, synthesis. Oh, whoa. Oh, interesting. Oh, I can make things. Nice. We'll do that later. I can recycle these guys. Oh, I recycled all of them. Now I can make robots. Oh, let's make it again. Oh, it works. Oh, it's cool. All right.
Maybe this is your magnum opus.
Yeah, maybe this. I don't think this is finished, though, so it's a secret. Yeah, I don't think I've shown this to anyone. Wow, what am I doing? I'm gonna recycle these guys. Oh, I need the information disk. How do I get that? No. Oh, no. Oh, look at my authoritator. What? Is there a question?
Do you remember having any, sleepless nights where you're just lying awake thinking about the design and the stuff you're going to put in?
For this game?
Sure.
No, I don't. Should I? Should I have been doing that? Oh, I got a smasher. Oh, it's being a smasher. Nice. Let's see what the smasher does. Oh, I didn't spend my turns, though. Let's go smasher. Oh, he does the same thing, but he's faster. Oh, these are smashers. I'm going against smashers. Yeah, they just have punching mitts instead of those are drills. Oh, no.
So I think since you have the source code for this, it's clear that you need to...
Finish this.
Finish it, yeah.
Yeah, I think it was definitely made in an old version of Flash, though.
Update it past Macromedia Flash to Adobe Flash.
Adobe Flash, yeah.
Question?
This is a really stupid question.
Is it? The high school Kenny made all the games in Flash. No, I don't.
Does mature Kenny make all his games in Game Maker now?
College Kenny made all his games Game Maker, and now future Kenny is making Unity games. So I had like three phases of engines. Huh. What's this? make a laser chart.
Why didn't you finish this game?
It's too hard to finish it. A lot of stuff going on, you know?
Yeah.
I think this is a... I think I made this like two years or something after the first, the original defense. Oh, what's this? Oh, everything's slow. Oh, I got a riffler. What is that? This is amazing. Let's see what the riffler does. Oh, just green. Oh, it just uses a lot of energy. Oh, energy is a thing. I think when I touch them, I just freeze, yeah.
So this was 2009, right?
I don't know. This might be 2010.
2010.
I think we jumped a bit.
Are we out of the chronology?
Oh, mini tank, what?
We're out of chronology now.
Yeah, I think because we were looking for the source code.
Oh, yeah.
When I found the new defense. Where do my robots go? Oh, yeah, right. Good point. I need more RM. Scavenge. Oh, I made a smasher. I think it's fine. Oh, my smasher died. Oh, dual turret. I wonder if definitely one of these is gonna. No, I need more energy. Oh, energy. Wonder what efficiency. Nope. Secret sauce. What's yours? Why would I tell you? But you're over there. That's not gonna end. Anyway. Okay. Wait. Oh. Look, I'm a tank. Oh, what's that? Oh. I think that's enough of this. Is that enough of this?
Let's move on.
Let's move on. Oh, right. Oh. Whoa. Look at these quality settings.
Oh, I do love that.
Oh, I mean, look at my stats. I beat 9 levels, killed so many enemies. Anyway.
I have a feeling you're going to be playing this all the way back on the plane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I had 2 of them open. What is this? Well, let's compare. Wait. Wow, look at that. Look how it changed. They're the same guy, though.
Yeah.
The art hasn't changed at all. Let's see. Yep, that's the same thing. Oh, wait. No, but now I can get max health. Anyway, close this. Source code. I don't know if it's going to work. It's been years since I've used Flash. It was modified in 2010. Yeah, so that was in 2010. I was 16. I was almost 17. Turned 17 in June. I don't have this font. So this is the stuff. I don't know what they do. Let's see. Edit. Where did I find the code? It's on the timeline. Here we go. Look at my code. Oh, this is just a button. It's not that interesting. What is interesting? Let's see this guy. Oh, these are icons. Nice. Stop. All right. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I haven't used Flash in so long that I have no idea what this does. Let's move on. How much time do we have?
All right.
11:50.
Yeah, we had like 20,
40.
40-ish.
40 minutes.
Minutes. All right,
that's enough. All right. 2010. Oh, this is like a year after the first defense. It's the Alphabet Monster. It was a sequel to Alphabet Eater, but it's exactly the same game. I was sponsored by Best Free Flash Game 247. Nice. Oh, look at my logo. It's pretty cool. Oh, look at that. This is my reggae period. To the jungle. Let's see how it goes. I think it's the same. Ooh. Too hard. Eat all the letters that come before it or are the same as you. Use the mouse to control your character in space to pause. Good luck. Oh. I paused. Oh. Look at this perspective. Look, I guess it's bigger and smaller. I think the sound effects are a lot better than this one. The graphics are pretty good.
So what games were you mostly into playing at this time in high school? Were you like mostly PC gamer, Flash, or console?
I don't know if I was allowed to play games. I played games on weekends. I forget which ones. I think I had a PS2. Yeah. Played a lot of online games because I wasn't allowed to play games. Which is why I make these online games. Perspective. I think that was the only purpose for the background. Oh, I died. Oh, wait, I have 4 lives. Oh, it's G, it's a C. What are those letters? J, G, G, and H. Yeah, this is how I learned my alphabet. Now I'm really good at, like, alphabetizing things. J. I totally made that website up.
Oh. You had a fake endorsement?
Yeah.
That's hilarious. So obviously this is a time where, you're, like you said, you're learning to code, learning to do graphics and work with sound and everything. Do you see any thematic relationship to College Kenny?
College Kenny is a different age.
Oh, it's a different period entirely.
Different period of my life.
Yeah. What happened? College, obviously.
I don't know. I don't remember. Things happen, though.
So you feel like there was a distinct break in style or theme between College Kenny and
I took like
a
three or four year break from making games for some reason before I started back up again in college. So yeah, 4 years is a long time. Yeah, this is the last game of high school, I think. What? Oh, yeah. I'm almost there. Uh-oh. Z? W. X, W. W, X, Y, Z. W, U, V, W. X. Almost there. Almost there. A lot of Z's. Z? X. Could it be? What's next? You will now be reset. Have fun. All right, I think it's the same exact game. Can I eat Y? I meant A. All right, what? I eat Y. Can I eat B? Can I eat Z? Can I just eat everything? What about F? Oh wait, no, I died. All right, it's a pretty good score, I think. More games. Uh-oh. Takes me to best free flash to get 247. Oh yeah, I could have done control Q. New defense. Oh, new defense was there. Oh, I'm gonna see Toast Escape. Concept art. That's it. It's pretty good, right?
Yeah.
Alright, so 4 years later, I think, junior in college. I made this game. This was after. There's a question. I studied computer science and math, and I took like two game design classes. Two of them with.
Both yeah,
of
with me.
Yeah. Maybe I took three game design classes. No, I took four. I took a game design minor. Your Spectrum. Uh-oh. No. I downloaded from itch.io. Go to my settings.
What's your password?
It's my name and then my birthday. Oh,
and
not
favorite
Sam.
Pizza topping.
Yeah, that too. I'll add that.
Can I use your computer to hack into the space bar?
The what? The space? That was a good joke. All right, now I can open it. Oh, look at Spectrum. Oh, look how beautiful it is. This is a new Kenny. Sound. Credits? Oh, look at those credits. Anyway, this is the first recursive game I made. So you're square. Oh, the controls don't work. Oh, it's just WASD for some reason. You can also swipe. Oh, I can't. So you're avoiding these stripes, and the stripes are filling the board. And then they fill the board. And then. Oh, I won! Now the purple too. Now the purple ones follow you. This game's pretty boring. Oh. But this one is definitely available on itch.io, I think, and it's also free on the mobile devices, which is cool. There's no ads. Oh, next level. What? No. What? You were born in 2000? I was born in 1993. You're young. Oh, no. You know my birthday. No, you don't know my birthday. You know my birth date. Wait, my birth year. Oh. I see what you're doing.
So it's really interesting to hear that you studied math in college, and that also this is when your interest in recursive game design starts to emerge.
Oh yeah.
It's all making sense now.
It's possible. Might have also been just drugs.
Did you say drugs?
What? No. Thanks. All right, after that was a game jam. My first game jam ever. I made in Game Maker. I wonder what this will be. Oh, what's this?
Oh, this looks somewhat familiar.
Does it? This game's called Core. I think it was Ludendare. My dad. In 2014. I think it was like 31 or something. It's tough. It's a lot harder than CIRCA Infinity. I made the music. It's pretty bad. I think it's two notes repeated over and over. Yeah.
And how many days did you work on this?
This is like a two-day game jam.
Wow.
And then it kind of changed my life. So that's cool.
Just do that. And this was your first game jam?
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh no, oh no. Oh, this is tough. No. Are you, should I? Oh, death.
I love the recursive question asking that's happening.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's intentional. Oh, this is a game, Colorolic. I don't think I've shown anyone. But this is another circle game. So it's like, you tap the colors that are there. So you're gonna match the colors next to you. Oh, and now you can mix colors. Well, it's moving. Oh, it's moving vertically. Oh no, I made purple. Look at that. My best is 152.
Really good.
How much time do I have?
About 25-ish minutes.
I didn't make a close button, but now I can control Q. It worked.
So that's unreleased? That game is unreleased?
I think it's out. Oh, so I worked with, like, I used to intern at, like, a design firm, like a two-person design firm, and they're like, hey, make a game. We won't pay you. So I did. And they released it for free. So you can get it.
Oh, I see.
It's another Ludum Dare game. I gotta hurry. Oh, here it is. Dive, demon, dive. Oh. So it's kind of like, what? Huh? Someone say something? Oh yeah, it is. Look at these. Look at these blocks. So this was like right before I released CIRCA Infinity. I was bored, so I did the game jam. So the goal is to like kill all the things, demon things. Sound effects were made by a friend named Gabe. Yeah, Gabe. He's also NYU. He's been in a game called Ape Out. It's good. Oh. Oh, now they're trying to butt stomp you. Are they? Is it? Easy. It's a boss fight. You're fighting yourself. Oh, you're dead. Oh, you're fighting four of yourself. And it's over. Oh, wait, no, it's not. I don't know how to do this. Easy. I won. Escape.
Amazing.
Anyway. Next game. This is an unfinished game called Kenny Gear Solid. It's inspired by Metal Gear Solid. Which should the graphics be?
A million.
Beautiful. Nah, it does. Good. Good. Fastest. Compromise. Oh, it looks terrible.
Is this your first Unity game?
Oh, it's Future Kenny.
Oh.
Oh no, the graphics are weird. But I shouldn't have put on fastest. Let me do this. Should I put on good? I'll put fantastic.
Was this your first Unity game, or is one before that Unity also? I missed the intro.
This is Unity. Oh no. So you can stop me. Oh no. Alright, let's try again. And look, he's sleeping, and you can capture him. Oh, look at him go. It's like Metal Gear. I just copied that game. Let's see if we can get to the end of the level. Oh, look at that. Look at that. We have the same sound effects. Oh, look at the guy. Ah. Me! What was the question?
Any other indie game developers that you were interested in or inspired by or following at this time?
Yeah, I play a lot of indie games. Play all of them.
All of them.
I think Spelunky's a big one. Idiot. That was the end. Oh, I got thick socks. It's like Spelunky. Oh, look at all these people I killed. Look at Virginia. Oh. Look at these people. Oh, Kelly, no. But I captured Patrick, so that's okay. Look at those people. And look at their live stories are just all the same. So there's like a base building part. It's kind of like the defense game, actually. Ashley. She's a builder. Patrick's sleeping on the job. I don't need to do anything. I need more researchers, I think. I should capture more people. Oh, look at this UI. Next level. Oh, what mission? What should I get? Slippers? I already have. I have thick socks though.
Slippers.
All right, slippers. Oh no. What are these lines? No. Oh no. Run away. Oh. Oh, music by Jack and Jim, who were friends. One of them is my friend, one of them is his brother. I don't know about him. I don't like him.
Mortal enemies.
Yeah. Oh, he's got a hat. Oh, yeah, hats mean you have to stomp on them twice. You know, it's still, like, trivially easy once you're already stomping on them. Oh, okay. Oof. Oh, he sees me. Oh no! Oh, this is over. It's over. It's over. Oh, it is over. Oof. I think this is the exact same level. Okay, it's procedurally generated, I think. But I made like one. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, I'm dead. I think it resets. What? Yeah, this is that's where my inspiration from Spelunky came in, was the question. And I think that's it. Anyway. This game. Last year I showed this game, but since then I released a free update called CIRCA INFINITY, which makes it really confusing. Look how cool it is. Oh wait, no, I went back to CIRCA INFINITY. I should go back to CIRCA INFINITY. Is it? No, it's not. So you can unlock color schemes. I think it's a Downwell thing. I stole it from Downwell. I'm still pretty good at this game. Oh, I got a new color scheme. Let's see what it is. Yeah. Color scheme. At level 3. So that's that game. How much time do I have?
Like,
I have 15 minutes. So I'm going to spend
minutes.
8 minutes on the game I'm showing here. And I'm going to spend 7 minutes on the other game, the future game. So this is the game that's showing at the arcade. That's me. Listen. It's pretty nice. Oh no, I won. I have to reset. I'm gonna reset it. Oh yeah, it's also really laggy for some reason. This is level 1. Wait, I'm gonna turn off the shader. Shader's so cool though. I'll turn it off. So yeah, the goal is just to match the colors of the triangles. And then eventually, there are more triangles. If the noise is... Some people were commenting that the noise is pretty creepy, so I added happy sounds. Oh, I was so happy. Let's see what's next. Let's go forward. Let's go forward in time. Oh, there's an eye. Oh, there's some eyes. Look, you won. Oh, no, you didn't. You know what the trick is? You just press once on each. Oh. Once on every. Nope. This is tough.
So I am really curious to know how you came up with the gameplay for this. Was it paper prototyping? Or were you...
I was like, how can I make a recursive game with triangles? And I drew it. And this was it.
Drew it on paper. Paper? Yeah.
Yeah.
So you had little, did you cut out little triangles? That's what I imagined in my head.
No, I just drew them.
No, just drew them.
I should have done that. Maybe I'll do that next time. My next triangle game. Let's see, we'll go... Oh yeah, so now the tips are split. So you can get different colors. Anyway. Wow, I'm so happy. Let's see if there's more mechanics. Oh, there's one. So now they're the middle. You have to match the middle color, which is these colors over here. Look at that. All these levels are hand-designed, not procedural at all.
Was that your method going into it, or did you try procedural and find it didn't work?
I tried hand-designed and found it didn't work. Oh yeah, I lied. That last statement was a lie. Some of them are procedural. Most of them are procedural. It's infinite. But yeah, I tried... hand designing them and it's pretty boring, so I decided to not do that. and do procedural, but with like some man design levels. It's kind of like desert golfing, if you've played that. You can, if you want to get the source code, you can make your own levels. This one goes for a while. Also, the sounds are pretty calming. It's a clock. Oh, you won. No, I didn't. So the trick to this one, you just tap them twice. Oops. I mean, there's like a way to solve it, but I'm gonna tap them twice. Mouse is cheering. Oh, now you can't spin this one. It's not a good mechanic. It just makes it easier. Yeah! Let's see what else. Yeah! Oh, now it's rotated weirdly. Oh, now they're linked. So when you tap one, the other one gets tapped.
Yeah! 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 Oh. Yeah!
Oh, this level's really hard.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
Oh. What's going on now? That was really cool. This level's hard.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Oh yeah, some of the levels just give bad frame rate. Look at the frame rate. So bad.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh, look at that. They're all wiggly. Why are they wiggly? I don't know.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, uh-oh. This level's too hard. This is a bad idea. Oh, this is a bad idea. Cut that level. What? Oh, wait, here we go. Oh. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, wiggly.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Oh, some noses. Oh, you didn't win. Look at this. Oh, those are cheering.
Yeah!
Oh, look at this. Whoa, whoa.
Yeah!
That was like level 115. Maybe I should space them out less.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
let's move on. How much time? I have 6 minutes. All right, it's my next game. Debut, I think. Yeah, debut. It's made of Unity. It's a box pushing game, but you're a pyramid. Look. Oh, what's that? What am I doing? Click, or should I do the two keyboard presses?
Keyboard presses.
Keyboard. Oh, I pushed the box. Oh, it's this. What's going on? Oh, it's getting quieter. Oh, what's going to happen? It's a TV show opening. Really symbolic, because this music is dramatic. It's in slow motion. Oh, look at that. Why are they falling? Eventually there'll be credits, but... Oh, there's credits. Ah, yeah. Name of the game. All right, let's play some levels.
I feel like that was the Mad Men intro. If everyone in Mad Men was like pyramid.
I totally copied Mad Men. Who asked that?
Who is Yankai?
Oh, who is he? Who do you think he is? Me? It's all of us. We're all Yankai. If you played Steven Sausage Roll, it's kind of inspired by that. Oh, you can also push them off, like, oh no. Look how slowly he's falling. Wait, this is a teaching level, so you can... So this is like the normal way of pushing blocks, but now you can also push them with the corner of your triangle. Do this level, I don't know. Sacrifice. How much time do I have?
A couple minutes.
Okay. Easy. That's the first world. Oh no, everything's falling. Guess what's gonna happen after everything falls? Guess what's gonna happen?
You keep saying you don't know what's gonna happen, but I think you do.
Do I? Oh, it's the same thing. Do you want to watch this, or should I pass it on? All right. We'll watch this as we wait. Second part. Let's play this as we wait.
As we're showing the last of Kenny's work, does anyone else have any questions they want to be sure they get in? So this is coming out in 2017.
What?
What was the texture that you put on the last couple games?
It's just a shader. This one's like the standard Unity shader. The one, the other one, and the triangle one had a custom shader that I wrote. This one. So you can also push them with like your edge, so like that. So you can avoid pushing these things also off. Last level. Oh, it doesn't exist. All right.
Awkward.
Well, that was it. That's the game. But wait, I still have to fill up some time. What? Oh, more defense. New defense or old defense? New, of course. I'll continue. I wonder if it saved my data. Oh, it did, yeah. But everything's undefined. It's like life. Oh, wait, yeah, after this, like, the levels just don't exist. Well, yeah, okay. Cool, Jenny's back, hey.
All right. Let's thank Kenny. Woo! We're going to do the old laptop switcheroo here. And then we'll be hearing from Jenny. All right, perfect. So Jenny, what are you going to be showing us today?
I think I'm going to show you all a little bit of my game here. It's called Daily Motions, and it's really just like a collection of games. Do you want to help me play through some of it?
Me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Jenny.
What?
Your favorite
pizza
topping?
I said egg.
Don't tell him.
And they're all really short, so do you want to play them? Or
do you want me to play them?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. You need the mouse too.
Okay. I'm going to bring my microphone. All right. I'm going to put on some makeup.
Yeah, you have 10 seconds to do your makeup. And I made this game in a week.
1 week?
Yeah. Probably in a couple of days. You need your other hand, too.
What?
Yeah.
have. Well, no. Where's my, oh, no. Oh, no. Liner.
Oh, you're awful.
I'm so good. Oh, lipstick. 40. That's pretty good. Let's try again.
Yeah.
Blush. Eyeshadow.
That's not where you put it.
Is it? I don't know where you put it. Is eyeliner? No. I gotta be faster. Hold on.
Oh god.
Perfect. This has gotta be good. 40. Alright, I'm actually gonna try now.
That was just warm up.
Yeah, it's warm up. Where do you put eyeshadow? Over there? Eyeliner?
Closer, yeah.
Lipstick. Oh.
Put on the mascara.
80.
Oh, okay.
All right, that's enough.
Yeah.
I'm gonna play all your games.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Oof, playing a lot of games today.
I made this one for Ludum Dare.
Oh. Is there sound?
Once you get past the screen.
Interesting. Interesting design decision. Oh, there it is.
Yeah, I composed it, and it's like, it gets pretty repetitive after a while.
It's like the music I make.
Yeah, basically.
But it's more notes, more than two notes.
So you gotta match the pose.
I'm trying. It's too wobbly. I gotta lift my body up. Oh, I did.
Yeah.
This is the same thing as the intro.
Yep.
Uh-oh. Almost.
Gotta lower your arm.
Oh, right.
But bring it back up again.
There you go. Oh, no.
Yeah, so close.
Oh, I fell. Oh, so sad. All right, this is tough. We gotta do that. Almost. Come on. Oh, I did it. Oh, no. Fallen. All right, gotta lift my leg.
Oh, yeah. You gotta get your head lower.
How do I do that? E? Spacebar?
Spacebar, yeah.
Oh, there you go. This is it.
Close.
This has got to be it.
No, space bar.
My
get
leg.
Your butt
my
up.
Leg's not working. Oh, no.
Oh.
Too far.
No.
How do I get out of this? Frog camel. What is a frog camel? Is that a real pose?
No.
That'd be cool. Oh no. I can do this. Gotta flip. Doing it.
Oh.
Wait, I gotta do my F. Oh no, don't do that. There we go. And then just the V. Oh wait, my eye. My arm.
V.
But my arm is like the wrong way.
It's okay.
Is that?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I think so.
Is there a cheat?
No.
Control win?
No.
Oh, it's getting there. Oh, yeah. All right. How many of that are there?
I think there's one more.
Is this the last one? Or one more?
I think so.
Okay, I
think
do
it's
it.
The last one.
All right.
Yeah, you're all cheating right now. Whatever.
What?
I think you're cheating right now, but it's
I'm cheating?
Okay. Yeah. It'll be fine. Let's just
what does that mean?
This.
Wait, what is cheating?
Sometimes like you don't have to match the pose exactly. You just need to get like the limbs and the head in like the right height.
Get my leg back. My leg's not going back. Come on.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
All right, now I get my E. Yeah, I won.
Yay, yeah. So this is a two-player game.
Can I?
So basically, like, the goal here is you're either an octopus or a hand with a fork. If you're the hand, you want to stab the octopus and avoid the wasabi. And if you're the octopus, you want to collect all the wasabi. So I guess I'll be the octopus.
Okay.
Fork. Okay. And if you want to, sometimes you'll get stuck on the table. So once that happens, you just right click. Okay.
So you want the wasabi.
Yeah, I'm trying to collect it all.
But.
And you're trying to stab me.
Why?
Oh.
Yeah. What?
All right.
Cheated. Come on.
Yeah. Also, you want to make sure that you don't fall off because this can happen.
Oh, squid loss.
So that's. Oh, no. Damn it. No.
Easy.
I guess we could show some other stuff.
More stuff.
Yeah.
Crunches.
Nah, I don't want to do that
one. You want to do crunches? Why not?
Nah. it's in this one, too.
Crunches are in this one?
Yeah.
Ooh. All right. Am I playing?
Yeah.
7:30 p.m. Make food. Sausage.
Mmm.
Hmm? What does that mean? I gotta eat. Is that you?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. Oh, you can click?
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful. Weigh yourself. What? You ate too much to gain weight. All right, I just won't eat then. Really need to lose some weight. I'm eating way too much. Diet starts tomorrow. Breakfast. Click to rotate food, fill plate, say under calorie budget. We had to fill a plate. I guess melon's pretty good. Is this corn?
Mm-hmm.
Egg. Oh, pizza topping. Perfect. I don't know if I can do it. I'm getting there. Wait, can I rotate these?
Yeah.
Oh, could it be? Oh, the cheese! Cheese is too much! That ruins everything. Can I rotate? That's the wrong type. Is that you?
No, it was the game.
It was the game. It was you and the game. How do you do this?
Use the two pieces of lettuce, or use the kale.
Oh.
You probably should start over.
Should I?
Yeah. Yeah, you can't rotate when you're on the plate.
All right. Oh, looking good. Looking good. Looking good. This could be it.
Nice.
Oh. yeah. Work out. Oh, the crunches?
Yeah. This is just the tutorial.
Alright, lunch. Oh no, it's gonna be a tougher puzzle. Do I use the kale and lettuce again? I think so.
Oh,
man.
Hurry!
I can't. I'm a failure. Steak's too much. Can't do steak. No.
It's my sigh.
games too much.
Oh.
Can I?
Maybe.
No, it's going to be too much. What happens if I go over the budget?
You can...
You got to do more crunches?
We'll see. Mm.
It's an idea. Uh-oh. Sweaty. Here we go. Oh, no. What's this? Oh! Oh, so sad. All right, it's going well for some reason.
I think there's one more.
Skype.
Yeah.
Ooh. Who's Bay? Some guy.
You are.
Me?
Yeah, whoever's playing this game.
Oh, I'm the
Bay.
You're
Skyping with me. Yeah.
Ooh, interesting.
You should close that.
This one.
Yeah.
Purchase bus ticket. Piece set due next Monday. Problem set. Send email to prof. Oh, someone's talking to me. Oh, it's you. Is that you saying? What if I say no?
Yeah, you can do that.
I don't want to. It's too mean. It's good. Thanks. How's your day? Mute. No. Sound baffle. Suspicious. Should I? I guess I haven't checked it out. Oh. Weird and dumb stuff. Oh, Animal Collective. Magnetic fields. Broken social scene. Oh, you're talking. Wait, no. I don't know that song. You're great. Oh, you butt. Cool.
Yeah.
Is there more?
No, I think that's it. You can just log out.
All right.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Yeah. Ooh. All right. So today I think I'm going to talk about the dieting game specifically, and show you like where it was at. Maybe like a year ago. So I was talking here last year, and I don't know if you remember, but basically, the premise of the game is I dieted a lot in high school, and I didn't really like how I looked, so I wanted to make a game about that, basically. So here are just some journal entries that I showed last year, actually, where I would, you know, write down my weight, track down everything I ate, down to the calorie, and, you know, I did this, like, pretty obsessive process of, you know, tracking down my food intake to the point where I started, you know, developing rules for myself where, you know, like, I would record everything I ate, never eat more than 1,000 calories a day, at least 30 minutes of exercise a day, drink at least one glass of water every hour or so. And, you know, like, these rules are pretty arbitrary and very restrictive. And there's not really any rhyme or reason to why I decided to, I guess, like, follow these rules. But when I started getting into games, I just like this idea of having a set of rules that you're following, just like was in the back of my mind. So I really wanted to explore this idea of dieting because I didn't know, like I didn't know many games that did that. Yeah, so this is also what the project looked like a year ago. I was taking a 3D animation class and I did a bit of modeling and I just really liked the low poly aesthetic. So, you know, I was playing with this concept of, I guess like figuring out what you're going to eat and having the game be centered around your meals. Yeah, and I guess I was also really drawn to my past where I would like, you know, have a private blog and have like photos for inspiration. These are other things that I mocked up that I thought would be cool to explore in the game. So I can show you where the game kind of ended up by the end of last fall. So you currently weigh 110 pounds. You need to lose 11 pounds to reach your goal. So basically the objective here is to stay under calorie budget, right? While not being stuffed. So something like this would be okay. Yeah, there's like a lot of repeating visuals. Yeah, so I spent that semester just really working on this one prototype. I spent a lot of time modeling the things and just really defining the visual style. But something that was difficult for me to deal with was that there was not really any game here. It was, you know, kind of fun to play around, but after the first, couple minutes or so, you get kind of bored. And the feedback that I got was people thought this was like a nutrition game for children. So clearly I wasn't really getting across what I wanted to get across originally. That's like one of the reasons why I think it's so difficult to make a game when you have an intention. Yeah, so these are just diary entries that were from high school and other, I don't know, like inspiration that I sought out for. So yeah, like the game just takes place over 3 days and you're just composing meals. And sometimes it's like kind of fun to stack them. Yeah. Yeah, but I mean, honestly, I wasn't super satisfied with how the game turned out to be by the end of the semester. Because although it looked kind of cool and cute, I didn't feel like there was much substance, and when people played it, they didn't really, you know, get a sense of what was going on. So in the spring, I decided to revisit the project and try again. Yeah, this is also a diary entry from high school. I don't really want to read it out loud because it's embarrassing and pretty cringy. But yeah, this is when I first started experimenting with, you know, these food pieces. I was really inspired by Anaanthropy's Triad. I don't know if anyone has heard of that game, but I just thought how, like, it's just so lovely how, like, concise and, you know, well-scoped it is, and that's something I wanted to try out with my games. I also went back to focusing on 2D because I felt like it was really challenging to I guess design in 3D. Like, I mean, this is also when I started like playing with vignettes or just like interstitials. Yeah, I reuse a lot of stuff. This is kind of confusing, so I took it out. Yeah. Yeah, so I kind of liked the direction where that prototype went, but I felt like there wasn't there still wasn't like much substance with this core food puzzle. So I created a version where you have like modes. So you can either have calories decreased over the days, have your play change, or have something randomly generated. So personally, I think like the plate one is a bit more interesting. And your goal is to stay under calorie budget while filling the plate. And you can click to rotate pieces. Yeah, so something like that would work. Yeah, and I think the goal of this prototype was really just to change things, you know, like change the plate size, change the calorie budget, and see if that was interesting. And I don't know, I still felt kind of dissatisfied with this. So yeah, I think during that semester I was like trying to figure out if I really should stick to this core puzzle of, you know, like organizing your food, and have that be the focus. I thought it was definitely better than the 3D prototype because there is at least some sort of goal that you're trying to strive for. But, I don't know, there is still something that, wasn't sitting well with me. So I'm eating too much. Whatever. Yeah. Yeah, so by I think May or June, this was what I had by the end of that semester, which is essentially like what you play in the collection of small games. Yes, definitely. Yeah, Nina is a huge inspiration, and I love how expressive and personal her games are. And I, you know, that was definitely one of the reasons why I wanted to make this game. Yeah. So this is essentially like the same game.
I'm really curious about the sort of combination of cute aesthetic mm-hmm. and how, like, especially the first prototype, I was shocked at how, like, fun the music was. But then it's also, like, a very sensitive topic, and maybe it's a little bit dark in some way. So I was curious, like, how you work those two things together or how you're thinking about it.
I mean, I would say naturally I lean towards like a really cute and silly aesthetic. A lot of my art is just, you know, like funny and loose and playful. And I kind of wanted to shift over that strength to my games. I don't think it came across super well with, I don't think it came across super well with the initial prototype because people would just think, oh, it's only cute and it's only silly and it's only fun. But I really wanted to explore like this juxtaposition of like seemingly cute and playful, but you know, as you continue to play the game, it gets darker and weirder and you know harsher on you. Yeah. So over the summer, I don't know. I was like really discouraged making this because I felt like with every prototype there were more things that I was dissatisfied with, and although I might have solved some initial problems like, oh, at least there's like maybe something that you do in this game, it still felt like you know, I was opening more holes. Yeah, so this is something that basically was an attempt to explore the core mechanic of eating. I guess like the things I like about this prototype is how it's a bit looser. You can see my expression, which I think is like more in tune with, you know, my current aesthetic. I'd say like a lot of my like the reason why the food game didn't really sit well with me was because it was just like very abstract and didn't capture that sense of playfulness, you know. But yeah, I guess like the difficulty with this one was I couldn't really figure out like what would be interesting with stacking these pieces of food besides playing with their shape, you know. Something else that that you know was a problem, I guess, was that food didn't really differentiate itself besides having a distinct calorie count, you know. And I felt like it was crucial to have some kind of behavioral differentiation in like the food that you're choosing. So I think that leads me to this prototype. Yeah, so this was built off of the squid versus fork game. Yeah, so basically, depending on like the food that you choose, you'll see. Oh, shoot. Okay, so I'm trying to feed myself, and I'm supposed to like force it in my mouth, but my head's trying to run away. So there's this like weird dissonance between, you know, like the player and the character. Oh, and now the head really wants that piece of steak, so it's going to try to chase it. So I need to avoid it. I like this one. I thought it was like pretty funny. But I guess like another question that I had was, well, how do I make this more difficult? You know, after the first 10 seconds, like it's a funny GIF. It's like cute. But you know, that was something that I guess I was trying to figure out with this. Yeah, score doesn't make sense. Yeah, so around this point, I decided to step outside of my comfort zone. I realized that with my development process, I primarily focus on visuals, and I tend to do those first. So when I make a prototype, I basically draft out everything in Photoshop and then save all the elements individually. So I guess a good example of that is currently I'm working on a dress-up game. And this is kind of how it looks like. So, whoops. Yeah, I guess. So I just, I guess I start out with having an idea of what I want to do, and I'll like sketch it out in my notebook, and then I'll basically draw each element so that it fits perfectly, and I don't have to like resize it in the Unity project. It's just so much easier that way. Let's see, yeah. So I think that kind of gives you a bit of insight of like how I go about making my games. And I was really doubting this process because I felt like, oh, it's this process works for making funny GIFs, and it works for making like very short, brief, you know, small vignettes. But it doesn't work so well when you want to like expand on this core, you know. And I was like really fixated on that and really wanted to figure out a way to do that. So that's why. That's why with this prototype, I tried to take the focus away from the art and just kind of create something that had like room for level design potentially. So there's like a weird mouth, and I think it's like pretty broken. You want to like throw the cookie in the trash can, and there's just like a few levels of that. I was also playing Hotline Miami and wanted to make like something stealth-like. Oh, shoot, yeah. And yeah, and this idea kind of also borrows like, oh, shoot, like distinctive behaviors depending on the piece of food that you had. Yeah, I'd say like that's something I like about this one. But yeah, it was like really uncomfortable working with this prototype because, I don't know, I just kept on doubting it and was like, oh, I really hate how this seems, and generally, like, I have a very clear idea of how the prototype's going to turn out to be. So, I don't know, it was scary to not really have an end in sight, you know, and I did eventually, like, abandon this one. Yeah, here's something small. My friend Gabe helped me program this arm. And this isn't even really a game, it's just like playing with stuff. Yeah, but I don't know, I think like I kind of got into this loop where I'd make something, you know, and spend like a couple days working on it and then try to judge it before anything was really made, and then felt like really hopeless about it and was like, oh, this kind of sucks, like I should try something else. And it was like this constant process of like trying and failing, similarly to like my dieting experience. And so I guess like what happened was I decided to, you know, like play to my strengths and, you know, embrace these small, weird, you know, mini games and prototypes, and, you know, build the game around that. And that's currently what I'm doing. So I would say this game is kind of triggering, so I guess don't look at this. You think it's okay to show it?
It's fun. If anyone feels like they're going to not want to see this, maybe leave, minimize your browser.
Yeah, so I took a course this past semester where I had to make a game a week, essentially, and for our, and each week there's like a prompt that's given to us. The second to last week, we got custom prompts, and my professor assigned the prompt, make a reprehensible game. So this is the one that I made. Yeah, and that's kind of where I like reuse this part in the larger game. Oops. Yeah, so you can like go through all these. And I feel like I just showed all my prototypes like really quickly. Yeah.
So do you want to actually pull up the final version of the game? Or let me ask, is it the final version of the game?
No.
Are you still in the design iteration process?
I'd say like right now I'm just making a lot of small games and just having, just like adding them to this collection of small prototypes. At the same time, I'm really thinking about, you know, constructing a framework to showcase all these small games.
That's cool. Yeah, can we see kind of like, now that we've seen all the prototypes, can we see the current version of it again?
Yeah, sure.
Now we can kind of see like what pieces made it in and what didn't.
Yeah. So the makeup game stood on its own, like more or less. And I think the theme for that game was less than 10 seconds or 10 seconds. Yeah, so, I don't know, I really liked how this game was, like, goofy and silly and let people share what they did. Like, that was something that I thought was successful about it. Yeah, let me try to get 100. I don't know if I'd be able to do it again. Oh, no, oh, no. I think that's it. Yeah. Yeah, and the yoga one was one that I made for Ludum Dare. And yeah, I guess like the way that I make games is just like have a very strong visual idea of what it's supposed to look like. And then just like play with it. So I was like experimenting with hinge joints in Unity. And like the whole thing is pretty simple. You just like add an upward force to each joint. And it just kind of creates this like weird, loose, funny game, I guess. Yeah, sometimes like if you hold down all the keys, like you'll float. People left comments. They're like, oh my god, like this is like a good superhero simulation. Yeah. And also all these poses are achievable because the way I made them was I took screenshots of like of me getting into those poses, so I know it's possible. Oh no. Like really not trying. Yeah, but I mean, so yeah, like that's one of the reasons why I decided to keep making more of these, because like, yeah, maybe I don't have a great, interesting dieting core, like food core for my dieting game, but I don't know, it's like good to put this out on the internet and like see people laugh about it, and you know, I feel like, oh, I'm doing something right, probably. People enjoy, you know, finding inner peace.
I love how all these games are kind of connected by, you know, there's this mechanic that's, like, difficult or kind of awkward, and it really mimics what it's like to exercise and diet and put on makeup.
Yeah.
Did you get any feedback from people, especially, I guess, about the dieting game?
Mm-hmm.
And how did that feedback sort of affect this or not affect this, or were people like, did they think it was fun, were they disturbed, were what did you hear from people?
Yeah, so I'd say like when I was working on the 3D version, I can bring that up. Yeah, like I would tell people the idea of what I was trying to go for. Oh, like here are some more photos of like stuff that I engaged in. So just like, you know, really obsessive, like calorie counting. I like wanted to make the focus almost like a simulation of my experience. But that like didn't really translate super well to a lot of people, especially people who didn't really diet or have, you know, any kind of body issues. You know, people who did have a similar experience to me were like, oh, this is so awesome. Like, it's really great that you're making this. It sounds so cool. But I felt like they were really relying on the strength of the idea rather than the game itself. So I don't know. It's like, yeah, it was good feedback, but I felt like I started becoming more harsh on myself because, you know, people would say, oh, this looks great. It's like fine. But to me, I felt like there were clearly problems to this version. So I guess like as that went on, I kind of like listened to my own personal judgment of like what the game needed to be. And I'd say like people like the feedback definitely was like more in line with what I wanted the game to be. But yeah, I don't know. It's like difficult to trust feedback sometimes because, or at least it is for me. Like I, you know, people will say like, oh, this is really interesting. I really like what you're doing. But sometimes it's all like clouded by like my own like internal, oh, like this isn't good enough. Like I don't really think people will get it. So it's like definitely something that I need to find a balance of doing. Yeah. Yeah, and I guess something else I wanted to try to get across is, like, you know, not having it be ultra-serious. Or, you know, have that come across in, like, small, brief moments, like the reprehensible prototype that I showed you. Because I think, like personally for me, I think sometimes, like, the most resonant pieces of work are, you know, don't take themselves too seriously and can laugh at themselves. Yeah.
Did you make the crunching sound effects too?
I think I probably found those on Free Sounds. Yeah, I know. Yeah. I don't know, should I like show other prototypes that aren't related to this? I could do that.
Yeah. Was this your first time doing mini games, or is that something you had played with before?
Yeah, so my background in games, like I started making games 3 years ago, and I primarily focused on the art. So I work with Alec Thompson, and we started making games together with Stellar Smooch, and then after that we worked on Beglitched, which is coming out next week. So, but like I'd say that my background isn't really, or it didn't start out with very much design or even programming, so it was definitely challenging to like figure out how to even think about design when the main, I guess, like blocking or block for me was programming. Yeah, so I think taking this prototyping class really, really helped me in terms of like, playing to my strengths and making things fast.
Yeah, I'm actually curious to know, were you a gamer before you started making games, and what were you playing? Distracted
you. Do you want to play? Yeah, I didn't really play many games prior to making games. That's so distracting. No, it's okay. Yeah, my brother and my dad played a lot of them, and I always saw it as like a waste of time, honestly. And it wasn't until college when I, you know, took a games course and saw the potential of games, and, you know, it kind of changed my life. Did you figure it out? No.
What? There's a way.
Yeah,
to
there
do
is
it.
A way. Yeah.
What is it?
I'm not gonna tell you.
No. Oh, okay.
Yeah, but this is like the first.
This is like the ice skating one from Multiball, where you have to like waggle gently and then.
Oh, possibly. I think you should be, like, take it slow and, you know.
Maybe the goal is just to like let it happen.
No. Oh, you're close. Yeah. Yeah, I was like so nervous the first week of class. I like, you know, didn't have much confidence in my ability to program. So, you know, I guess this is like when I started thinking in terms of like, oh, what would look really funny and what's like something easy to implement? And you kind of see that as like a theme through a lot of my work. Yeah, you're supposed to tread water here.
Oh. All right, you do it.
Yeah, okay. I actually... No.
It's coming back.
Yeah. I think it's like... Oh, no. Oh, wow. I don't know what's happening.
Oh, there we go.
Okay. Yeah, I think it's like that.
Oh.
Yeah. But yeah, that was like just kind of a proof of concept. Yeah, that's basically it.
Eventually you die anyway.
Eventually you die, yeah. You get tired. Yeah, the second week was a strict theme, so we had to make a Robin Hood game. And this is kind of the one I came up with.
It's a puzzle game.
Is there no sound? Yeah. I was playing, like, I played Ending, and I really liked the movement. Yeah. Oh. There's actually, oh, no. There's no grid in this game because I didn't know how to make a grid. So actually, everything is just like incrementing by like a fixed step. And it's just like this one level. Oh, shoot. No, wait. I think I just bit crush them, like using, I don't know, make it sound crunchy, like that's all I know, or like add distortion to it. I think I use chip tone, if anyone's used that, it's like a great sound effects website, or you can just create your own from it. So, what's this one? Yeah, I don't. I think this one. Was just something that I threw together pretty quickly. We had like two choices of music. So I like just wanted to make something kind of weird. Like I learned how to do instantiation in like my class from last year, so I basically took that script and like reused it, and then added like a ton of shaders to make it look kind of cool. I know it's like atmospheric, I guess. I like the colors. What? Yeah, I know. It's intentional.
Please re-release that as a screensaver. I would love.
Yeah, totally.
It's amazing. Like the best After Dark module.
Sure. Yeah, week 5 was trying, which was like the squid game. Actually, yeah, this is like that's the new version, but the one that I did for class looked like this. It's like also kind of 3D. Because I missed like modeling, and I'd really like to do it again, but it's basically like, yeah, you've never seen that screen, yeah. The end screens are all the same, yeah. So when I like redid it, I just swapped out all the 3D models for 2D assets, yeah. And then we've seen this one, which is like the crunches one. Yeah, so you just like want to use as many as possible.
Ooh. Yeah. Oh yeah, I remember
Yeah, I remember that too. Do you want to play this one, mate? All
right, what is it?
It's a two-player game. Oh. So we had like this week was also a strict theme. We had like a box art auction, and you had like hypothetical $100 to spend on a piece of art. So I got this one for pretty cheap, and I had to make a game based off of this. So this is the game that I ended up making. Yeah. So you're the burglar, and you want to steal all the 10 items, and I'm the grandma, and I need to catch you. And you can turn on and off lights.
Cool.
And you can also, like, hit the power box, too. So.
Whoa, what? Oh.
Move slower, too.
What happens?
Oh, got you. Yeah. Ah. Right.
So you're selling all this stuff? What do the lights do?
It's, like, difficult for you to see what's in that room. So I want to turn on all the lights. So you don't know, like, what you're missing.
Oh, I see. Get away.
Yeah. Oh, no. No.
All this stuff. Where'd I go? Oh, what? I'm invisible. Oh,
yeah, yeah. Like, when you stay still, you can see where you are briefly. But if you move around, like, you kind of blend into the dark. So try moving around, like, really fast. No, just hold down.
Oh.
Yeah.
Where am I? Oh, no, turn on the light. Where am I? Oh. I stole the cat.
Oh, no. I'm going to wait for you here.
Oh, yeah. Wait, you're in there? Oh, yeah. You're hiding. Oh, yeah. It's a stealth game. Did it get everything?
Yeah. It's not like totally balanced, but...
Get away. No.
Yeah, so...
Brutal.
So I actually have a question for both of you. How does it feel to play your old games in front of a bunch of people? Are they better than you remember, or is it a little cringy, or how has it been? Especially, yeah. I guess, for you, Kenny, since your games go way back.
Oh, no,
way back.
It's great. It's great. I love it. yeah, it's really fun seeing, like, because, I don't know, those games were made, like, 9 years ago, so, like, I was a totally different person. So, like, I might as well have been playing a game by, like, another random teenager.
Yeah, I don't know. I still cringe at, like, a lot of my old stuff and current stuff, too. It's, like... Like that Skype game, it's like, oh, I don't really want to watch you play. Yeah, this was also like a strict theme where you have to, move with only one.
Why is it autobiographical?
This one? Yeah. Oh, because I was like rushing to meet the deadline and like didn't want to work on this game anymore and felt like,
a giraffe?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, how is it autobiographical?
I don't know, I just wanted to add that.
Oh, okay.
Was that part of the assignment?
It being autobiographical? Uh-huh. No, it's just make like a one button game, but I thought it'd be funny to add that to the title screen. I like the neck crunching sound. I think I found like frozen vegetable sounds on free sounds, and that's what I use. Oh, yeah, and your head fell off, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, and then you see the makeup one. Yeah, this is the one that I started and never really finished. Like, I can show you some mock-ups. It's funny, like, Kenny, when you showed that music game, or like...
Music game?
Yeah.
Oh, xylophone game. Yeah.
Magnum Opus. Yeah, I had like a similar idea where like I wanted to make something with like music. Maybe we should collaborate or something. Yeah. But that one, I like couldn't think of making something interesting with that one. So I ended up making the yoga game for Ludum Dare. I think the theme was shape-shifting. So, so for week 11, we had to make a fan game of someone else's game in the class. And I was a huge fan of this one game called Climbed and Quartered, which was made for the box art prompt. Yeah, this is the box art. Have you played this? Wait, you should. Do you want to try it? Yeah. So you basically want to climb, and I think you use like.
Oh no.
Use. Oh man, I love this game. I don't remember. I think you find it. Yeah, you just keep on climbing. Okay.
What are the letters though?
I don't. Okay. So let's figure this out. R and T. Are for this arm. I think.
Oh wait, I'll do the right side.
Okay.
All right. Y. What?
U and Y to go up and down, and then F and G to go. Oh, you're H and J. Yeah. So let's go up.
No.
Oh shit. Oh no.
All right.
Let's go. No.
There's got to be a way to move sideways, right? It's just the moving.
It's like if you notice, like the bars things, change yeah. too. This game is by Burgess Boschel.
Cool.
Yeah. He's so cool. His stuff's awesome. Yeah, I love this game.
That's my fault.
Oh, you want to try it by yourself? It might be easier that way.
All right.
-1.
No, it's not easier. It's way harder. Oh, I have to climb.
You have to climb, yeah.
Wait, that's...
No. You're gonna...
One. Wait, my feet.
Oh, my feet.
Here we go.
Yeah, you're getting it. Yeah.
Easy.
Now you have to watch out for the spikes.
Oh, there's spikes.
Yeah, later.
This game's too hard. Oh, come on.
Yeah, go check out Burgess's work. His Twitter handle is just @Burgess.
22. 63 is your high score?
Yeah.
Do it.
No. Okay, let's try it.
You might need to exit the game and then pop back out so it'll get on the projector.
It was bad, but... Spikes.
No. Okay. Oh no. Okay. No. Yeah, so that's the game. Yeah, it's really funny. Okay.
Do we have any questions for either Jenny or Kenny? Or anyone else whose name ends in any?
Third question?
Was there someone with a question? You shout out. I can't see you. Yeah, sorry. Go for it.
Yeah, that's definitely something that I want to play with. I feel like I need more prototypes to do that. So like a plan for that is to prototype some of that, mapping in Twine maybe and see how that goes. But yeah, definitely. I think the...
Oh.
Yeah.
What is this?
No.
This is not us. This might be our cue that our block is up.
Yeah, are we done?
It is about time, actually. Oh. Do we have any other questions? Yeah, there's a hand up.
The question is, what motivates us? Jenny, what motivates you?
Like the feeling of working on something and like forgetting that time is passing.
That's good. That's a good one. Same.
Any other questions? And if you're sitting near the light, you can just shout them out.
How long did it take you to make the game that you submitted?
In total? I don't know. I think like each prototype except for the big dieting one took a week or less. And the dining one took place over a semester, I'd say. Yeah.
Yeah, and Yankai's Triangle was like 3 or 4 months worth of weekends, I think. Yeah, I have a job.
And what? I'm still in school.
What do you do? What is your job?
I work at Harmonix. It's a coder.
All right. Any last questions? Awesome. Nobody? All right, cool. Well, we're just about at the end of our time, so join me in thanking Kenny and Jenny.